And we're the family and friends of the children and young adults who developed the sleep condition narcolepsy following the swine flu vaccine pandemics. It was 3 years ago since the vaccine. Today is the first anniversary of the Irish report confirming there was a link between the vaccine and narcolepsy. We're here today outside Hawkins House, inside the Department of Health, to call on the government, the state, to put in place the package of supports they promised these young people this time last year.
Well, it affects in very different ways. Like, you could be asleep in class and like you might miss out on a few things. Some days you could be so tired that you can't actually go into school because it affects you so badly. And then the cataplexy is also hard because you could be out with your friends and if you start to laugh, you could collapse on the ground. And you have to wait for a few minutes until you get back up because if you get too emotional, you just collapse and it can affect in a very different way. Sometimes if you're on like hard ground, you could hurt yourself, you could cut your knee or something like that as well if you're on hard ground.
The father of a boy who's 8 years old, who was diagnosed last year with narcolepsy as a result of the pandemic vaccine that he got in 2010. We've latched onto the Every Child Matters campaign that they ran last year. For the referendum, and we're asking the simple question, what's different about these children? They count. We want long-term support for them, we want them to have a good future.
We're wearing yellow as like a kind of symbol, just bright colours, and just to get attention to people so they'll notice us and notice that this is serious. And